Welcome back, it's Citizen7 playing Prison Architect. It's episode 2 and we are just about to let in our first prisoners. They will arrive in 2 hours and 15 minutes, that's where we left off. So if you watched the whole last episode, it was about 45 minutes I think. Thanks for that, it was just planning and construction and I feel like I didn't really talk all that much and I didn't really give too much commentary or dialogue, but maybe you liked what you saw, and if that's the case, then thanks for enjoying it. Alright, so let's go ahead and grab this right here, subblock A. Hey, $20,000. And our prisoner capacity is 16, so as soon as we unpause it, we're gonna get that other 20, get that 40 right there. Let's also grab, let's see, prison maintenance cleaning, groundskeepers, visitation rights. Ooh, yeah, we're gonna need a common room. Let's do that and see what's up. One, hey, look, we got that grant. All right. Let's clear out some of these planning markers that we don't need anymore. Now that the rooms are what they are, they don't still need to be marked. Ding. All right. Oh, no one can get in there yet. Let's make this a little more useful and throw a large jail door right there. That's where we... Eventually this is going to be a hallway, so putting that there allows us to just dismantle it later and have an open hallway between these sections. Our prisoners arrive in an hour, let's keep an eye on that. I'll run it at speed 2, just because I don't want to miss the prisoner arrival. Dismantle this and put a... And it blinks at me. A concrete wall in its place. All right. This prison block is all ready to go. Let's start to get this common room outfitted. And the visitation room as well. 10 minutes. I can find visitation, throw that down in 10 minutes. And here they are, here they come. The first 8 prisoners. Let's look and see who we have. Paul Waymark. A kidnapper. Felix Mundy, he has a reputation that we do not know. Psychologist required to show needs. Yep, I need to hire him. Let's go ahead and do that. Stephen Redman, just a guy. Shin Shadow Gen made seven victim with a katana as murder weapon, killed the lights of the apartment where he was staying, and made his move before one of the victims made a call with the police. And yeah, he's sentenced for assaulting an officer. All right. Got a ninja here, a ninja wannabe. He's strong and stoical, so yeah, he sounds like a ninja to me. This is a guy to keep an eye on. Ed Simpson, he's stoical. Warren Bray, nothing special. Simon Pittick, nothing special aside from his awesome name. And this guy's fearless, Stephen Moss. So, one bio. 3 guys with traits that we know, 1 guy with a trait that we do not know. Let us get them going in. We've got a guard here ready to escort them out. Let's throw in another guard just to make this faster and easier. And where is our psychologist? Mr. Psychologist? Ah, we need to make this an office. This is where we want him to go. as soon as we get the objects in there. That will become an office. This being the psychologist's office, is going to need a couple chairs for the people that he is counseling. These guys are carrying their things. Let's speed it up to 2. Lockup time. We should take a look at the regime. Free time's coming up, then some lockup. Let's adjust this. Throw some free time at the end of the sleep period. Shower time, lockup time. Give him a little more free time. Eventually, this free time is going to turn into work time. We'll leave it at 2 meals right now. But eventually, I think we'll probably implement 3 meals. Have some yard time, a little lockup. Let's make it free time. So you have to go from your yard to your cell, and then you can have free time, then you can eat, then you get locked up and sleep. I don't really feel like I know a lot about the way to make an effective regime, so if you have comments on what makes for an effective regime, go ahead and throw those in the comments, and I will read that and take that into account. We can station people, right? No, we don't have deployment yet. Why don't we have deployment? Why is this not progressing? Oh, because we don't have a security man. Let's hire a security guy. Psychologist's office. Security chief. There you go. Let's get you your office stuff is in place. So now we just have to designate it. And since we have our psychologist, we go ahead and designate both offices, because I'm not worried about the psychologist taking over one of those. Chief's office, there you go. Please get researching. And let's get our foreman. Let's get him hired. There we go. And let's get these guys doing their researches. An extra grant for you. Get our cleaning men for you. You're doing that. Why don't you work on prison policy? Very important. And then we'll unlock the health. Get some doctors, some teachers. Oh, shit! Well, we fucked up big time. We didn't put a prison door. Well, there we go. First big mistake. Now you know what kind of a game it's going to be. Remember how we talked about how there's no 3-wide door? And instead of doing something about it, we just let people run the hell out. I originally said I wasn't going to put the door gates in place right away. Now I'm wondering if maybe I should. Because if I do it here, it's going to require a policeman to walk all the way down here to open it. And that's not going to do very well. But we can put one here temporarily, and it'll be a pain for these people. When they get tired, they'll have to get some guard to open the door. But I think it's probably going to open fairly frequently for trucks, and it won't be a problem. Let's just put those in place. Because that was really embarrassing, and you all got to watch it. In my defense, it is almost 2 o'clock at night, and I'm feeling a little sleepy. Feeling just a little tired, but, you know. excuses are excuses. What do we have left? 1, 2, 3 guys. They beat up these guys. This guard is hurt. These guys, he was stoical. He doesn't really care about being in prison, so he didn't even try to escape. There's one. And where's our last? We should have 6 guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we don't see our last guy right now. So maybe he's about to run off the map. Exciting. Oh no, there he is. They got him. Oh, who did we lose? Simon Piddick didn't get away. Ha ha. The guy, the unknown guy we still have. Our stoical prisoner. Did we lose the ninja? That would make a lot of sense. Let's check it out. One. No! The ninja failed to escape. Some ninja you are, Shadow Gen. Alright. What were we doing before all that nonsense? Let's go ahead and throw some visitor tables in here. We have room for quite a few. I think this visitation room is going to... it's gonna handle us for a long time. Okay. And, you know, we can put another row down the center if we need to. We can fit a lot more in there. But, you know, for now we'll do that. I don't mind taking things apart and moving them around later. What we don't want to have to do is let's see. We can open this for them. Come on. Open. Oh. Of course, now yard time's over. It's the problem with having this prison really spread out like this is that it's actually not... excuse me. It's actually not effective at all. Oh, Lord. That is the worst. That is the worst. We're going to have to move that. What's he doing out there? What's he doing out there? I don't even know. I don't even want to know. Okay. We need a common room. Let's type it up. We're going to need to make the doctor really fast because all these guys are going to die. Which would be awesome. Common room. Like I said, I find these things really hard to find because I guess they must be sorted by some sort of category, but it's kind of nonsensical to me. I expect some sort of alphabetical order, and there is none. Let's see. Okay, the screen is facing outward. 1, 2, 3, 4 televisions. And let's give them some sofas, wide sofas. There you go, you can watch TV. And let's throw a few chairs in this common room as well, because later we can have Alcoholics Anonymous meetings in here, which is always useful, and then we can clear that out. We know what that is. We know what that is. And how are we doing at this point? Clear out these dots. In fact, this path not strictly necessary to see that anymore. Let's just take it out because it's a little messy. And I prefer the clean look. We know this is a yard. All right, what else? Our yard needs some weight benches. Let's go ahead and get those in there. And we've got prisoners arriving, 12 prisoners, which 6 and 12 is 18. That's going to put us 2 over. We are going to have some people in the holding cell until we get our next cell built. So, let's... The fastest thing to do is going to be to do that. And tough tooties, guys. You can share a toilet for a while. Someone is waiting. Solitary. We haven't built solitary yet. Someone requires medical attention. Yeah. Let's build our solitary and our medical next. Medical is going to get just a regular door. So you have to go be able to see the doctor. Let's get that happening again. And actually, let's take a look at our grants. Health and well-being. Build a medical ward and 2 doctors and a psychologist. Hey, that's what we're working on right now. Prison maintenance. Let's wait on that. Staff well-being. Staff room. Have some guards. Let's throw that on there, why not? This is security. Alright. You know what? Let's make this into a staff room briefly. Can always shift things around later. An hour and a half until our people arrive. Let's try and be aware of that. Oh, the cleaning cupboard is right here. Let's just type that and put a door on it. 1 hour. I don't think that we have a situation where everyone is just going to escape again, so... But we do need to get started on this second cell block. Yeah. Let's go ahead and do that. Actually, we'll just make the cell block, put the jail door. They can go right into that. Do we have... What's going on in our bureaucracy? Let's get our patrols going so we can get some health. Yes. Research groundskeeping. And what's our current situation? Yeah. Let's... Oh, look, 15 prisoners coming next. Turn that off. Well, we are off to a bad start. Gonna do this, let's see. Get things going again. Workmen, oh, look at that. Gonna have to tear that down and build an actual wall. Get your lights in. And... We are going to need toilets. We are going to need toilets here. So we will run a large pipe all the way from here. Up to here. And, you know, this will serve to deal with these blocks when we get them. But we'll put the toilets all the way in the back. Get that happening before we put those walls in. Put a jail door on the solitary cell. Why not? So a large jail door on the solitary block, and I will build this wall here. Let's see, what are our needs currently? Considering how badly everything else has gone, the needs are pretty good. The environment is actually one of the worst things right now, and is we actually have the ability to hire some janitors. So let's hire some janitors. Start cleaning this place, please. Let's have two janitors. Why not? How much do they get paid a day? A little bit. Everyone seems to be sleeping just well, and these people who are going to end up in the holding cell aren't going to be happy, so we need to get this happening as soon as possible. That's not what I want to do. Let's get these walls. Eventually we'll unlock the cloning tool, but for now we can just do this the slow way. And this is going to bring us up to 32. 32 is a decent number of prisoners. Should be able to get a little bit of money. We're going to need some more guards. Let's go ahead and just hire some more guards. I've got 3 right now. Let's have 5. And let's set up some patrols. Can I do that yet? No, I cannot. I can station a guy. Let's station a guy here in this block. And let's station a guard in the canteen. Currently no access to this classroom, but that's fine. Got a guard in the canteen. We've got a guard in the place. Let's put a guard out here as well, so he's always there to hit the doors. And once we have patrols, we'll actually make him walk back and forth there. That'll be more convenient. And let's hire another, make it 5 guys total. 5 guards, 18 prisoners. I think probably that's a low number. Let's go ahead and grab 6 guards. Especially because this here needs to be unlocked. But now we have a guard stationed in the canteen. He should be able to let people in fairly well. Let's station a guard in the yard. In fact, 1 guard in the yard. Hire a guard specifically for that. All right. Let's check those needs. Needs are still amazing. No critical needs. Do we have any wait benches in here? No, we don't. Hey, guard, open that. Can't you see there are prisoners waiting? Let's go ahead and grab some wait benches, though. Wait bench. It's time to work out in the yard. Put these down in a nice little pattern that's very inefficient, but looks cool. And I keep seeing these prisoners. That should be enough to handle them for now. Come on. Freaking open. Oh, the guards are busy. No available guards. 3 are resting. All right. So it's not actually a problem. If someone could finish this, could start getting medical. Medical bay. I think this fence counts as a wall. So let's find out. Security, staff room, blah, blah, blah. See, I can't find it. I know it's here. Kitchen, shower, yard, storage, deliveries, garbage, security office, infirmary, that's what it's called. Infirmary needs a medical bed, and it counts as indoors, so there we go. Let's get some medical beds. Two will do for now. We've got the money. Let's have three. And actually, doctors cost $1,000 a piece, and then we have to pay them. So let's go ahead and get our two doctors. People can start getting their medical help. Let's put the speed up. Oh, look, this guy died! Good lord. Simon Pittick, you fool. I wonder how he died. Does it tell us that? Let's pause the game. Alright, so this guy died of overdose, and about 25 minutes in. Let's go a little bit longer. I'm gonna have to. I've not really done this before. I need to write down my start and end times. This guy is injured. Why is. Oh, he tried to escape, and he needs solitary, but there is no solitary. Whoops. So, we need to make some solitary so that he can be punished instead of just sitting in his cell. Are they just ignoring him now? That would be really crap. I'd hate for his needs to just build up. Hey, you doctor, can you actually go and help him? That would be super cool. It's 10, it's late. Alright, we have prisoners still who are having to live in the holding cell because close, thank you. Because we haven't finished this block, so let's finish this block so that that doesn't have to happen. Table. I'll just hit the three right now. Did we pipe this already? I bet we did not. We did not. Let's do that. Toilets. Toilet, toilet, toilet. And yeah, we're gonna do the rest, but I want to get, instead of giving them a million things to do at once, which I've already given them a lot to do at once. I kind of want them to get these prisoners out of the holding cell and into their own personal cells. So let's do that. Hey, look, patrols are done. Let's research contraband so that we can try and stop people from overdosing. And let's start education. How are we doing? For money, yeah, whoops. Let's go ahead. Wow. Let's get our education on. Let's research prison labor. We're not gonna, I was gonna say we're not gonna do that right away, because with prison, once prison labor happens, some prisoners are going to help move things out of here into the storage closet, which isn't currently tagged as a storage closet. So let's do that. Storage. There you go. Don't want to see that. And that's now storage, so not important. Yeah, the deliveries area is a little bit full, and once we have prison labor, prisoners will try and get out here to help pick it up. So it's really important that these road gates stay closed, or prisoners can't take away that body. Prisoners will probably run out again. It's probably set up right now that prisoners are going to run out, and some of you have probably already noticed how and why, and are poking at your screens, yelling at me, and I hear you, except I don't hear you. I have no idea. So it's fully possible. Why are there two guards in the yard? Come on. Tired. Preferring to rest in a staff room. We never built a staff room. Damn. Alright. Let's get two more guards. Got one guard in the yard. One guard just chilling in the yard. Let's put a guard in visitation. Oops. So what I actually want to do is hire two guards. Now we have five guards without assigned duties. Get the staff room. Oh, and ensure that none of the staff are exhausted. That could take a little while. Let's declare this a staff room. Oh, wait a minute. Is our holding cell... That's what we... Why are you sleeping in his bed? That's not cool. Let's put the speed back up. You. I'm gonna fire you. All right. Let's get these cells happening. Really want to get these cells happening. Get the people out of the holding cell. Turn the holding cell into our staff room. And for now, let's put a guard there. And let's put a door there. A door, double door. Let's do that so that we can also put a guard... come on. Put the door so I can assign a guard to the common room. This is filthy. Where's our janitor? What's he doing? Maybe let's just lock this open while you guys are making the construction. Please and thank you. Going on. Oh dear. It's the infinite hearth loop. I don't think that I actually have a dead body. I think that they took the body away already, but for whatever reason it's not registering, so the hearth shows up and then drives away. But I don't know, because they're gone now. Hey, look, doors. Put a guard there. Guard. Cells! Good. Alright. Let's get everyone out of the holding cell. Guard, you're in there. Do I have a free guard somewhere? I do. But you, can you actually go in there, please? No one's there. Okay, good. Dismantle. Dismantle, and let's make it a staff room. That's what I want it to be. All right. Let's get rid of that. Hey, and look, they're in the staff room. Everyone, it's like, staff room. And everyone's like, let's rest. So I guess we know that now that they do actually rest in the staff room, if there is one, because they just did. That was pretty interesting to see. Let's put a bin so that they can, I love it. You can tell that it's a British game because they call it a bin. That's great. What's up, Kim? Oh dear. Get some drink machines in here, please. Hey, no staff are exhausted. Let us immediately change deployment. No one there. Oh, no one's exhausted. Come on, no one get exhausted. Rest. As soon as that happens, there we go. We got it. All right, now we put the guards back where they go. Guards in the canteen. Let's finish the solitary wing. Three staff members are exhausted. One is still awaiting solitary. All right. And in the morning, we're going to shake down. Let's get this solitary built for the night. This door is a problem. Lock it open. That's this door. No longer needs to be locked open because there are prisoners in there now. So. We have a toilet sitting around, so we get that for free. These other toilets, I'm gonna buy. And then, uh-oh, careful kitten. And everything is breaking because of the cat who needs to leave the room. Pause. Come on. Yeah, come on. Yes, out you go. Crisis averted. All right, let's go back to full speed ahead. Get some freaking solitary rooms done. And let's tag them. These three. There. I bet they put them in the one with no toilet. Alright. One thing I learned the hard way is if you stretch over rooms that aren't quite, they haven't finished the walls yet, things are bad. Oh, look. Five prisoners say they are well treated. Let's take a look at what's going on there. Some people are hungry. Okay, it's morning time, though. They're showering right now. The family and recreation is starting to build, and people need to use their toilets. They can do that. They can do that, indeed. All right, family and rec. We need to make sure that these needs are getting met. That's going to... Visitation we've got. Hey, look, Curtis's mother and father are here. Where's Curtis? Let's find out what he's doing right now. Prisoners. Curtis, where are you? Hey, look, he's coming to see them like a good son. All right. And these cooks are cooking along just fine. Let's finish this. I definitely want to finish this cell block. Let's open that for that guy. Open, please. Normal mode. Naked guy just running around. His name is Jay Bird, and he's running around. Go figure. Did we not read our second... Oh, our second dish of prisoners showed up, and we didn't even read who they were? Failing. Totally. Alright. Solitary is done. Two staff members are exhausted. Let's finish this cell block so we can bring in new prisoners. We need to put beds in those. Oh, he's cleaning. The janitor's cleaning. I'm like, what on earth? All right, and toilets. Go. Let's get these shower heads in here. Drain, 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 drain. And also shower heads. Two, three, one, two, three. 16 shower heads for 16 prisoners. It's perfect. Just keep that door open while the guys are working, please. It's just as convenient. Everyone else is eating. No one is really causing a fuss right now. What are their needs? Needs are going really decently. Someone is mad about hygiene. I bet it's the guy who was locked in solitary. And family and rec, important. Let's put a few phones into the common room so that they can get to those during their free time. Carrying toilets. Alright, is it yard time? It is yard time. Open that yard. How come you didn't open the yard, stupid guard? You know what? You know what? Let's stop that and make it a patrol right across the door. There you go. Let's remove that and make it a patrol up and down the cell block. These guys, 1, 2, 3, 4, alright, and we said we're gonna take him out of there and make him patrol our exports to delivery zone. Oops. There we go. And we've got three guards there, and then three guards who are just running around. We said we were going to do a shakedown, so let's actually get one new guard and shake him down. It's lockup time. Shakedown time, boys. What did we find? One needle. Oh, that's it so far. One screwdriver. I am really surprised. I wonder if something has been done in Alpha 27 that really turns down the aggressiveness of these medium prisoners, because usually my danger level is usually gets up to medium, and it's almost always increasing. We've only found three pieces of contraband. I mean, granted, we only have 17 prisoners and 128 places, but I'm really surprised. But I guess that maybe it's possible that goes to show that putting these guys out here has actually made a huge difference. Hey, someone found drugs. Hey. All right. A huge difference in contraband. And if that's the case, I am very, very pleased. Let's give these guys each a bin. And we got a bin in the staff room to help deal with that as well. I wonder if anyone knows what the appropriate place, like the best way to use bins. Oh, we found some shears and a drill. Damn, son. The most appropriate way to use a bin is, I figure the kitchen probably needs some bins. Yeah, for sure. That's amazing. We went through a shakedown and hardly anything. There were only 128 places, but that's pretty good. One needle, one medicine, scissors. Hey, woot woot. Four are waiting solitary, and guess what? We've got the solitary. We can do it. We can throw them in the slammer, and they can stay there. Let's get some guards. Let's get some guards up in there. There's no reason not to have him walk around! Check it out. Alright. Two in solitary, two are waiting. Come on, guys. What are we? Oh, we just need some doors. Let's throw these doors down and get more prisoners in this place. Because things are going well. I'm really happy. I'm really happy with that shakedown. And, whoops, here we go. Alright. Gonna finish these cells. And let's go ahead and assume that they are going to complete tonight. We're gonna bring in more prisoners in the morning. Nine guys. Yeah. Got it. Let's do that. And got you going on bureaucracy, security. Let's call this security room, which is basically an office. So we can start using our getting some. Ooh yeah. Let's see. Contraband. Informants. Recruit prisoners under duress. I doubt that everyone's pretty happy. Oh, look, it's the ninja. He got locked up. Everyone has been pretty happy. I don't think anyone is going to be under duress and want to report to us. Let's see. He's just a tiny bit suppressed. Oh, he's a little more suppressed. And he's on drugs, and he's tried to get out. Jay Bird has a knack for killing victims, especially with bottles. He breaks them in half and stabs his victims repeatedly. He prefers Coke bottles over Pepsi, and ironically has a pet polar bear, but either way, to him it gets the job done. Yeah, Jay Bird running around naked before I remember. Go figure. And he had drugs as well, just a little bit intoxicated, a little bit suppressed. Nobody is really into telling us anything. Ninja man. All right, let's look at our prisoner list. You know what? I think we missed out on that, sadly. While we have it paused, let's go back to the informant screen and see. This guy's stoical, tough instigator, someone that we don't know, stoical. Is this the guy from way back, Felix Mundy? Yeah, we don't know. Ugh, come on. Don't close on me. Just because I hit escape doesn't mean I want you to close. And two of our guys, we've got four people in there right now. All right. Things are going well. All right, so this needs the typical office things. Let's go back to full speed ahead. And let's put a staff door on there. Keep people out of security. Ding, 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 ding. What do we need? An office desk. A chair. And a filing cabinet. This. We could put CCTV and door control and, you know what, a phone tap, which is part of the new upgrade to have phone taps. Very cool. I think we might install one or two. Why not? What's going on? We need utilities. Because we have no power right there. 9 prisoners arriving in an hour and a half. Somebody build me that, please. That's okay. You know what? This is a classroom. It's supposed to be a classroom. Let's put a door on it. Oh, they're here. Let's check them out. Who do we got? Mike the Mole Master. Mike the Mole Master Diamond Thief was finally caught after digging into a police holding cell. Proof moles are blind. Hey, I like that. Felix Hancock, nobody. Nothing special. Tim Western, nothing special. Paul Lee, nothing special. Matt Hole, he's stoical, but otherwise nothing special. Oliver Green Arrow Queen, a billionaire and a former playboy turned vigilante archer. Oliver is the son of the late Robert Queen and the late Mariah Queen, the maternal older half-brother of Thea Queen, the best friend of the late Tommy Merlin. All right. If that's a bunch of Green Arrow references, I know nothing about it. Hopefully it amuses somebody. All right. Matt Big Cook Schollenberger. He was sentenced to prison for 6 years for involuntary manslaughter for failing to accurately predict the location and scale of the earthquake in Maryland. On top of that, he was also charged with petty theft for not returning 50 Shades of Grey. Oh, that's not one you should have kept, bud. There's way better books out there for the BDSM lifestyle. Though, you know, maybe he stole it as a favor. What is this? Guard. Why does the guard require to be enclosed? What room? I don't know what's going on here. Something needs to be enclosed, but it's not. You know, maybe he didn't want to return that as a, you know. Oh, look, Borislav Bruce. Izmastevi, I don't know. I was born in Russia when I was young. I bought Gaelic and I was the boss of Russian mafia, but one man betrayed me. All right. I don't know if that's a Russian word. That means something bad, probably. Probably. Seems likely. He was born in Russia. He was born in Russia, but now he's here. And you know what? We're going to treat him the same as every other prisoner. Let's pause the prisoner intake because we've got 9 guys arriving. And currently only room for 6 more guys. You think we can build 3 cells in 24 hours? I don't know. Let's find out if we can do that. This is going to be the end of episode 2. So if you enjoyed it, thank you very much for watching it, for putting up with my poor playing. Go ahead and throw your rants, your comments, your advice in the comments section. I will read all of that. I'm recording this on the same night that I recorded episode 1, so I won't have had a chance to look at anything you may have posted on that episode yet. Anyway, very exciting. I'm having fun. Things are going really, really well in this prison. It's shocking, absolutely shocking to me how well things are going. Which I guess means that Alpha 27 might be a little bit easier than some of our previous builds. Anyway, Enjoy the show. Enjoy the game. See you later.